This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, so in the last session we have discussed our module pool and we had an issue in that drop down list works. Okay, so I recreated the program with my previous class, same example only, nothing changed, it was working fine, and I shared the recording also. Request all of you to just go through that and try from your end also. It will work. It is working fine also. Done. Now today, in continuation to this module pool, we have what BDCs. Again, in BDCs also, we'll be discussing what module pool. Okay. So this BDC stands for what? Batch Data Communication. Batch Data Communication. So what is the purpose of BDC? It is used for migrating the data from legacy system to what? SAP system. Legacy system means non-SAP system to what? SAP system. Okay. So it is something like this here. Just to understand the purpose. Suppose we have a company called as Reliance. Okay. This Reliance is running their business from 1970, for example. So from 1970 to 2015, okay, from 1970 to 2015, they might have captured some huge amount of data. They might have captured some customers' data, vendor data, material data, purchase order data, sales order data, the data which is specific to their business. Okay, so this data. Okay, this data they are stored in what? Some legacy system. So it can be some text file, or it can be some Excel file, or it can be some other database. So huge amount of data is maintained all these years of business. Now in 2015, assume that the same company has decided to migrate their business to what? SAP. The same company has decided to migrate their business to what? SAP. Okay, so now assume that the implementation company is Wipro. So Wipro is implementing SAP for which customer? Reliance. So this is a new implementation. Try to understand, this is a new implementation. First time we are implementing SAP for what? The customer called as Reliance. So initially what happens? The customer might contain some legacy data, some old data. Where is that legacy data is maintained? In some text file or Excel file or some other database. So what you have to do now as an ABAP consultant, we need to read the data from this, because it is not possible to re-enter the data in the new system. We have to write some program. Okay, we call it as BDC program, which will read the data from this legacy system and migrate the data to what? SAP database tables, using what? BDC techniques. Understood? So the main agenda of BDC is, if you are implementing SAP for the first time to a customer, okay, we need to check whether your customer is having any old data. Okay, your customer is having any old data. That old data should be migrated to what? New software. What is the new software here? It's just like if you change your mobile phone, what are the old data is there in your old phone? You will be what? Copying it to what? The new SIM. Okay, something like that. Okay, here also the legacy data is copied to what? The SAP system, SAP database, and this is done by using what? BDC techniques. Hope it's clear to everyone. Okay, so here these files, this text file or Excel file, whatever I'm talking, these files can be either on the local machine or it can be on the server machine. Okay, it can be on the local desktop or it can be on the application server. So if it is on the application server, okay, one second. Yeah, so see here, the files can be on what? Local system, or the file can be on what? Application server. Application server is where the SAP is installed. Okay, so what you have to do as an ABAP program, you need to understand the location of the file, whether it is on the local machine or whether it is on what application server. So what you will do, irrespective of whether it is on the presentation system, that is the local system or application server, we'll get the data into what? Internal table. And from internal table, you'll migrate it to what? SAP database. Am I clear? So this is the way to handle the files. Files can be on the local machine or it can be on the application server. So as part of this BDC, we'll see both the scenarios, how to deal with the files on the presentation system, nothing but local machine, or how to deal with the files on the application server. We have to get the data into internal table, and from internal table, if you want, you'll do some validations and then we'll migrate it to what? SAP database. Okay, so this is the overall scenario. Hope it's clear to everyone. Any questions so far? So there are many BDC techniques. Each technique has got its own benefits and limitations. Okay, so we'll be seeing all those techniques. So one of the techniques is what? Direct input method. What you are doing in the direct input method, we are just reading the data from legacy system to what? Internal table. And from internal table, you are directly putting in what? SAP system. You are directly migrating it to what? SAP system. I am not doing any validations here. The data is stored in internal table. From internal table, directly you will insert into what? SAP database. Okay. So here, already we know in our SAP system, related to customer, we have a table now. So if you go to ABAP dictionary SC11, we have a table what? KN1. What is the purpose of this table? It stores what? Customer master data. So assume that my business, okay, is having what? Some old customers data. Maintained in what? Some text file or what? Excel file. Okay. So this is my KN1 table in SAP, which has got how many fields? 215 fields. So it is not guaranteed that your text file should also contain the data for all the 215 fields. I may have the data only for what? Few fields. So what I'll do now is see here. Yeah. So by using direct input method, I want to migrate the data from legacy system to SAP system. First, we need to understand what data is there in the legacy system. Okay, we need to sit with what? Functional consultant. We need to understand what data is there in the legacy system, whether it is customer data, material data, vendor data, cost center data, sales order data, invoice data, purchaser data, whatever the data or any customer specific data. That data we need to analyze. We have to sit with the functional consultant. We need to understand what data is there. We need to understand how many fields are there per record. What is the separator? What is the delimiter between the fields? All those things we have to understand. Then we need to understand to which tables the data should be migrated. The data might be migrated to one or more tables. So we need to understand what are the corresponding target tables where the data has to be migrated. Okay, so in this case, if I assume that customer data is there, so let me take a file here. Suppose I'm having a file in D drive. Okay, I'm having a file like what? See, you can see we have a file what? Cust. We have a file, text file. I'll take a simple text file. Okay, where it is available? In the D drive, in the local machine. In D drive, I'm having a file called as cust.txt. Okay, so assume that this is the data. Okay, so what is the data? Something like this. 7 a.m. CST 8, 7 a.m. CST 9, 7 a.m. CST 10, and something 7 a.m. CST 11. So assume that this is my customer data. Okay, my business will tell that I'm having a file where I'm having the old customer data. So we need to understand what this data represents. So my analysis is the first field is what? Customer number. Second field is what? Customer country key. And the third field is what? Customer first name. So I understood that this file is having what? Customer data. and I'll understand that maximum I will have three fields per record, and each field is separated with what, comma. Then I need to analyze what is my target table. Okay, so in my SAP system, what is the table which stores the customer master data? K11 table. Okay, so we need to collect that particular information by sitting with what, functional consultant. But my K11 table is having how many fields? 215 fields. Okay, but my legacy system is having the data only for those three fields. So we need to understand what are those three fields. Okay, we have customer number, we have land one, country key, and we have what, name one. So out of 215 fields, my file is having data only for what, three fields. So I need to identify the target tables. I need to identify the target fields where the data has to be migrated. So blindly we cannot do the migration. We need to sit with the functional consultant. We need to sit with our business, I'm going to say customer team. We need to understand the data in the legacy system, understand the technicalities of the data, understand what is the delimiter between the fields, understand how many fields are there per record, understand what is the corresponding data, target database table, analyze what are the fields in the table where we need to do the mapping. After analyzing this entire information only, we need to develop the BDC program. Now my requirement is I want to transfer this data as it is to my SAP system. I don't want to do any checks. I don't want to do any validations. I don't want to check whether this is valid data or not. Okay, what are the data is there in my file? I want to migrate it to SAP as it is. Okay, so I'm not going to do any validations. I'll go for what, direct input method. Read the data from leg system, put the data in the internal table, transfer it to what, SAP system. So this is the data I want to migrate. Save it. Okay, 7 a.m. CST 8 to 11. How many records are there in my K11 table as of now? We are having some 9,156 records. 9,156 records are there as of now before I do the migration, before I have done the migration. Okay, so any questions so far, please ask me. I'll repeat once again, before writing any BDC program, understanding and analyzing the legacy system data is very important. Okay, so just by looking at the file, we will not understand. We have to sit with our business team, with the functional consultant, understand what data is there in the file, understand what are the target tables in SAP, understand what are the target fields in SAP, understand the delimiter in the file, understand how many fields are there per record in the legacy system. With that analysis only, we can develop the BDC program. So let me do it now. I want to do the migration using direct input method. Where is the file available now? On my presentation system, on my local machine. What is the file name? D drive, cust.txt. And what is the separator? Comma is the separator. Done. So let me develop the BDC program. So as part of this BDC only, I'll be covering what, file handling. File handling is part of BDC only. Data migration from local text file to what, SAP, what is this, comma delimited. Done. Executable program, save it in the local object. Done. Now the first step you have to do is how to read the data from what, local system text file. No, in S4HANA, they'll use some data provisioning techniques, Srikant. Data provisioning techniques. Okay, we have many data provisioning techniques like SLT tools. By using SLT tools, SAP landscape transformation tools, okay, the BWBI consultant, they'll do the data migration. That's what S4HANA, okay. But I'm talking about what? Non-HANA database. I'm talking about non-HANA database, okay. If it is HANA database, yes, they'll use some data provisioning techniques which are purely for what? That HANA database. Done. So now I'll just develop the program. So where is the file available in my local machine? What is the file? Text file. So to read the data from local text file, SAP has provided one function model. So if you go to function builder, SC37, we have a function model. GUI_upload. We can use this function module. We can use this function module to read the data from what? Local text file to what? Internal table. What are the mandatory parameters here? See, file name is what? Mandatory. File name type what? String. Sorry, file name type what? String. And all are optional. What does it do? It reads the data into the internal table. So whatever is in the tables, you have to understand that is what? Internal table. Transfer table for what? File contents. So the two mandatory parameters. So I have to give the path of the file. I don't want to alt code the path of the file. I want the user to select the file. I want the user to select the file. So what I'll do is cm. That's the parameters. P_file_name type what? String. Okay, try to understand. I want to accept the file name. I want the user to select the file in the runtime. So my requirement is when I execute, here I have to give the path of the file. Instead of we art coding that, I should provide some F4 functionality. When I press F4, it has to open me the open dialog box. It has to open me the open dialog box. So what I'll do now, what is the event triggered? Already we know all these things. Whenever I press F4, what is the event triggered? At selection screen on value request. So I'll handle a event at selection screen on value request for P_FNAME. Already we discussed this in the earlier classes. Okay, at selection screen on value request for P_FNAME. I'll just give a message just to check whether the event is getting triggered or not. Type what I. Let me save it, check it, done, execute this. Yeah, I'm getting the icon. I'll press F4. Yes, the event is getting triggered. But our agenda is what? I should display the open dialog box where the user can choose the path of the file. So for that, what I have to do is SAP has provided one function module. If you go to function builder SC37, we have a function model F4_file_name. Okay, so this function model I can use to display the open dialog box from which the user can select the required file. So F4_file_name, it has got all our what? Optional parameters. What does it do? Yeah, it returns what? The path of the file which is selected by the user. Path name selected by the user with the help of what? File manager. What is the path of the file? It is of type IBIP params-path. IBIP params is a structure. If I double click on this here, IBIP params is a structure. In that, what is the field they are referring? Path. What is this character of what? 128. Local file for upload or what? Download. So I'll try to use this. So it is returning the path now. So I'll declare that variable, try to understand. Data, what? V_path, type what? So and so. Try to understand this. I'll call the function model what? F4_what? File name. All are what? Optional. I'll just remove this, or else if you want you can view this, or is not required. Directly I'll receive the path. What is that? V underscore what? Path. Done. Let's save it, check it, no errors, done. Execute this. When I press F4, okay, yeah, I got the open dialog box. Let me cancel this for the time being. Yeah, so now what I'll do is here I'll say if V underscore path is what, not initial, I will say P underscore F name is equal to V underscore path, and F. Save it, check it, done. Or here only I'll write it. Why there? Save it, check it, no errors, done. When I execute this, yeah, see here, I'll just browse this. I'll press F4. Where is it I stored in the D drive now? So in the D drive, what is the file name? cust2.txt. cust2.txt. Or cust.txt. I'll choose that file. I'll say open. Done. I got the path here. D drive cust.txt. So instead of V art coding, I selected that path from the open dialog box. So how do we populate that open dialog box? By using a function model called as what? F4 underscore file name. It will display the open dialog box. And whatever the file you have selected, that path will come and sit in this variable. If that path is not initial, I'm assigning that path to my screen field. P underscore what? F name. Done. So I'm able to select the path. Done. Now what I'll do is, okay. Yeah, now I have to read the data from that file. I have to read the data from the file and put it in what? Internal table. So what is the function model we use for that? GUI underscore what? Upload. We use the function model what? GUI underscore upload. What is the signature of this GUI underscore upload? File name, which is a what type? String. You have to give the file name as a mandatory parameter. It returns the data to what? Internal table. So I need to declare one internal table first, then only I can store the data in that. So I'll say types, I'll just declare one internal table. See the technique here. Begin of ty underscore temp. Okay, so in my file each record is having how many fields? Three fields: customer number, customer country, and customer name. That entire thing is string only now. So I'll declare one variable str type what? String. And then I'll say end of what? Ty underscore temp. Done. Then I'll declare one internal table, data t underscore temp, type table of what? Ty underscore temp. Then I'll say w underscore temp, type what? Ty underscore temp. Done. Check it, no errors. Yeah, so see the technique now. When I click on this execute button, I have to read the data from the selected file. What is the event triggered when I click on the execute button? Start of selection. So I'll say start of selection. Done. Here I'll say if what? P underscore F name is what? Not initial. If it is not initial, then what I'll do? I will say read data from what? Local text file to what? Temporary internal table. Okay, so I'll call the function model GUI underscore what? Upload. Done. File name. What is that file name? P underscore F name. And these are all optional. Done, 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 done. Internal table. What is the internal? I declare T underscore what? Temp. Done. 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 That's it. Else, I'll just give a message. Please select a file. By pressing what? F4. Type I. Done. Done, done, done. Okay, so first let me execute, then I'll explain. Yeah, I'm not selecting any file. I click on execute. Please select a file by pressing F4 input field. Done. I'll press F4. I'll give the name of the file. What is the name of the file? Cust. Okay, cust.txt. Done. I'll click on execute. System is trying to access the file. Do you want to grant access? Allow. Look, I might have got the data. Okay, so I'll debug, just try to focus. I'm running two events, start of selection and at selection screen on value request. Done. When I press F4 here, what is the event triggered? At selection screen on value request. I'll say F4. Done. We're about to call this function model. What this function model will do, it will display the open dialog box where the user can choose the path of the file. Okay, so I'll press what? F8. Done. I'm choosing the path here. What is that? What is that? Cust.txt. Na? So I'll choose cust.txt. I got the path. I got the path. D drive. What? Cust.txt. I'll click on execute button. What is the event triggered? Start of selection. The event triggered is start of selection. I'll click on this. Done. Now in the start of selection, right? In the start of selection, if p underscore fm is not initial, yes, it is not initial. Done. I'm trying to call this function model. What this function model will do, it will read the data from that given file and stores the data in the internal table. So if you see this internal table, as of now it is empty. So when I say F6, it is trying to access the file. I'll say hello. Yes, I got how many records? Four records in this particular internal table. Check the content. If you see T underscore temp, yes, it has got only one field, str, and it is storing the entire data. So this entire data, concatenation of customer number, customer country, and customer name is stored only in what? One field, str. Done. I got the, so what we understood so far is I got the data into what? I got the data into what? Internal table. Okay, so this is what is the requirement. I have to read the data into internal table, and from internal table I have to insert into what? SAP system. Okay, so first of all, any questions so far, please ask me. Any questions? Okay, if there are no questions, now I'll ask the question. I got the data into the internal table T underscore TMB. Now tell me, how do we proceed further? I have to insert this internal table data to my SAP system. In that SAP system, to which table? K11 table. So how do you proceed? What is the next step now? Anyone? Yes, anyone? Raghavendra, Srikant, Vamshi, Chinna.
You can use modify statement. You can update the data into the database table.
Okay, so what you are trying to say is, okay, so now I'll say if T underscore what temp is not what initial. Okay, so I got the data into the internal table. Okay. If T underscore temp is not initial, how do we, okay, this is the internal table. How do we insert the data into internal table? Sorry, how do we insert the data into database table? Referring to an internal table, modify what? Database table from table what? Internal table. Modify database table from table, internal table, or I can use insert also. I can use insert. Okay, but the problem with insert is if any duplicate record is there in the internal table, it will lead to runtime error. That's why better to use what? Modify statement, which will either insert the data or it will update the data. So should I say like this? Modify, what is the database table? KN1 from table T underscore 10. So this is what you are trying to say, Chinna?
Yes.
Yes. But is this valid? Is this valid? Others, is this valid? Ah, Raghavendra, tell me.
No, sir. We need to loop that e underscore temp. We need to split it. Then again, we need to put it in the related column.
Okay. So why this is not valid?
Because the column.
Correct.
Yeah, the work area and the column names.
The structure of database table and the structure of internal table is not compatible. Is K11? K11 is having 215 fields, but this internal table contains only one field. That's why it is not valid. So when I do syntax check, I got an error. The types for the database table, and the internal table are not compatible. Understood? So this K11 is having 215 fields. Your internal table also should contain what? 215 fields. But this index I only one field. What is that field? SCR. So I cannot directly say like this. So this is what? Invalid. This is what? Invalid. So what I have to do now? I need to, okay, I know that my file contains, each record contains maximum what? Three fields. So now what I'll do, transfer data from temporary internal table to what? Final internal table. Okay, so what I have to do now, I have to declare one more internal table, types begin of ty underscore what? Final. Okay, I know the format of the file na? Yeah, is my voice is audible to everyone? Hello,
audible? It's audible.
Yeah. Shivani, it's audible for others. Okay, done. Ty underscore final. My file is having how many fields? Three fields. What are those three fields? Those three fields are referring to what? K11 only, na? So I'll declare those three fields. Kunnar type what? K11-Kunnar. Then what is the next field? Land one type. K11-Land1. Next, name one type what? K11-Name1. Then I'll say end of what? T_Final. Then I'll say data. T_Final type table of T_Final. And also W_Final type TY_Final. Understood? So on what basis I declare this internal table? I know that my legacy system file is having maximum three fields per record. And I know that those three fields represents the fields of what? K11. That's why with that analysis, I declare this particular internal table. So now what I'll do, I have to split it. So I'll say loop at, what is the temporary internal table? Loop at T_temp into W_temp end loop. Then here I'll say clear W_final. I'll say split W_temp-str. Split W_temp-str at what? Comma into the target fields. What are the target fields? W_final-custom_number, W_final-land1, W_final-name1. Okay, name one. That's all. I'm splitting it. Then I'll say append W_final to what? T_final. Done. I got the data into this internal table. Done. Now what I had to say, if T_final is not initial, I have to update it to database table. No? So can I say like this now? Modify KN1 first of all. First of all, let me debug. Okay, there's a warning related to KNN. Just ignore it. Yeah, I've activated this. Now let me put the breakpoint. Just try to focus. I'll put the breakpoint here. I'll give this file, execute this, done. So if you see, we have two internal tables, t underscore temp and t underscore final. What is the difference between these two? If you see t underscore temp, it has got only one field, what? STR. If you see t underscore final, it has got three fields, Kunna, Lanvin, Neman. As of now, both are what? Empty. Now what this function model will do, it will read the data from local text file. It will read the data from local text file to the temporary internal table. So when I say F6, hello, I got the data into a temporary internal table. So if you see, this entire data is stored only in one field, but I have to split it field by field. So what I am doing here, I am looping that. If it is not initial, I am looping that. So each record will come to work area. Na? So I got the first record, combination of customer number, country and name one. I'm splitting into what? Individual fields. After splitting individual field, I'm appending it. Okay, done, it is appended. Yeah, I got the first record, loop it again. We are splitting the second record, again we are appending, right? So I got the data into the final internal table. Okay, I got it field by field. I got field by field. So then if it is not initial, yeah, if it is not initial, now, can I say like this? So what is the agenda now? I got the data into final internal table. I have to put it into SAP system. So can I say modify KNN from table T underscore final? Is it valid or invalid? Is it valid or invalid? Yes, anyone, is it valid or invalid? Yes, is it valid or invalid? Invalid again, because KNN is having 215 fields, T underscore final is having only three fields. So again, it is invalid. When I do syntax check, I got an error. The work area T underscore final is not long enough. It is not long enough. So they are not compatible. So again, this will give me what? Syntax error. So what I have to do, I need to transfer the data to the internal table, which is having the same number of fields of what? KNN table. So what I'll do now, I'll declare one more internal table data. I'll say something what? GT underscore final. Okay, type GT underscore final, type what? Table of what? KNN. I'll declare one work area, GS underscore final, type what? KNN. So I declared a internal table and work area referring to what? My dictionary table, KNN. Now what I'll do, I will loop it again. Loop at what? T underscore final into what? W underscore final, done, end loop. Then I'll say clear GS underscore final. I'll say GS underscore final hyphen what? Customer number equal to W underscore final hyphen customer number, GS underscore final hyphen what? Land one equal to W underscore final hyphen land one. Then GS underscore final hyphen name one equal to W underscore final hyphen name one. Then I'll say append GS underscore final to what is that? GT underscore final. Done. After this, I'll say if GT underscore final is not initial, if it is not initial, then you what? Insert or modify what? Legacy data to what? SAP. Okay, now I can say what? Modify, what is the table name? KNN from table T underscore what? KNN. Modify KNN from table T underscore KNN. Then here only I'll say write number of records affected, number of records affected is psi db count. It will contain the count of what? Number of records affected. Means it can be number of records inserted or combination of number of records inserted or what? Modified. You understood? So what I'm trying to show here is, this is my direct input method. What you have to do, you have to get the data from legacy system internal table, and from internal table you have to put into what? SAP. So to what table I have to put? Into KNN table. So this internal table also should contain the same number of fields of what? KNN. Okay, I don't have data for all the fields, but the structure should be what? Same. That's the reason I took all these three internal table. So first I'm using GUI upload. I'm reading the data from file to the internal table as it is. But here the entire record is stored in what? One string variable. I have to split it field by field. So what is that next logic I'm writing? I'm looping the temporary internal table. I'm splitting that particular string into what? Individual fields based on the separator. What is the separator here? Comma. So I got the data into T underscore final. This also contains what? Only three fields. This also contains only three fields. Then what I'm doing? Since I cannot directly insert into KNN from T underscore final, again I declared one more internal table which is of type what? KNN and work area of type KNN. I am looping this internal table and I'm appending it to the final internal table. I'm appending it to the final internal table. Then if it is not initial, we are modifying the KNN from table, so on. So done. Activate this. It is activated. Oh, errors are. I got the errors. Where? T underscore KNN. Oh, not KNN boss. What is this? GT underscore final. Modify what? KNN from table. GT underscore final. Let me save it. Check for the syntax error. Done. Activate this. So before I execute here, if you see the table KNN, how many records is the 9156? Okay, 9156. And what is the file I am trying to what? Insert here, cust.txt. Yeah, what are the country keys here? See, AB, IN. Okay, first of all, these are the customer numbers. Now, do you have this customers in KNN table? Let me check. What is that? CM7MCST8, not there. 9. Not there. 10, not there. 11, not there. Okay, so these records are not there. Now you can see what are the country keys here. AB, IN, IN and AR. AB, IN, IN and AR. Okay, so in SAP, what is the table which stores the country keys? T005 is the table which stores the country keys. T005 is the table which stores the country keys. If I go to contents, right? If you see the countries here, okay? If I give IN, IN is there, India. IN is there, India is there. AR, Argentina is also there. I'll give AB. AB is not there. So this country key AB is not defined in my SAP system. But your file contains what? One of the record is having what? AB, na? Okay, so it is an invalid country key. Even though it is an invalid country key, I am not doing any checks here. I am not doing any validations here. So the data will be blindly inserted into what? SAP system. Am I clear? This statement will not perform any checks whether this is a valid data or invalid data. So in this, there are some record. There is one record where the country key is AB. AB country key itself is not defined in SAP system. So I'm trying to migrate the invalid record. Then also it will take. So let me execute this. When I say F8, then this is my file, right? Execute. System is trying to access the file. Do you want to grant access? Allow. Number of records affected is what? 4. Now, if you go back and check the table, okay, earlier 156, now I got what, 160. And if you see this record, what is the country key here? Country key is what? AB. But still it is what? Inserted. Still it is not migrated. So, direct input method, what is happening here? We are getting the data into internal table, and from internal table, we are directly inserting into SAP system by using what? Insert or what? Modify statement. It will not do any checks whether this is a valid data or invalid data. Okay. So it is fast only because it is not doing any checks. Am I clear to everyone? Performance is very much faster. But the problem with this approach is what? There is a possibility of migrating what? Invalid data. Okay. So it is not doing any checks. We are directly migrating that. So is this clear to everyone what I have done? So in this, we understood what points, how do you populate the open dialog box? How do you populate? By using a function model called what? F4 underscore what? File name. This will open me the, this will display me the open dialog box where the user can choose the path of the file. Then we understood how to read the data from local text file. What is that function model? Geo underscore what? Upload, which will read the data from local text file to what? Internal table. Okay. And what is the separator in this? Comma is the separator. So since the separator is comma, I need to use what? What? I need to loop that internal table, split that into individual fields based on the comma delimiter. Once the data is stored in the final internal table, we have to migrate it to what? SAP by using what? Insert or what? Modify statement. I'm using the modify statement, which will either insert the data if not available, or it will update that record if it is already existing. Any questions in this part, please ask me. Now I'll do a small change. What is that small changes? Here, what is that file I have considered? Cust.txt, cust.txt. So if you see here, we have this file. Now I'll take another similar file, cust2.txt. Cust.txt. What I am doing here, in the earlier case, it is a comma delimiter. Now this is what? Tab delimiter. Tab delimiter. This is my data. This is my data. The separator in this is what? Tab delimiter. Tab delimiter. So what I'll do now, same program, let me make a copy of this. BDC2. BDC1, I'll copy it to BDC2. I'm copying BDC1 to BDC2. Okay, so the small change we need to do is, in the earlier case, we had the tab delimiter. Now, if you go back to that function module, what is that? Geo underscore upload. Okay, we have the function model geo underscore upload, right? So in this you can see, what is this here? There is an optional parameter as a field separator. What is the separator we are having? Tab, na? So see the description. Columns separated by what? Tabs. Columns separated by tabs. So now I need not take the temporary internal table, okay? Because I'm having what? Field by field data. Na? The separator is what? The separator is what? Tab. So what I'll do now, I'll directly say, the only change I have to do is, I don't require what? This temporary internal table. I'll take only this internal table, which has got how many fields? 3 fields. Okay. If it is not initial, file name, what is the parameter I have to consider for tab delimiter? As a field separator. as a field separator equal to what? X. As a field separator equal to what? X. My default is space. I am setting it to what? X, which indicates what? Tab delimiter. Tab delimiter, done. And here you directly get into what? T underscore final. Done. Else done, 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 done. Yeah, this logic is not required now. This logic is not required. Directly I can say if T underscore find not initial, again I have to put it to the final internal level to be compatible with what? KN1. That's it. That's it. That's it. In this end, if is not required, done. Let me save it, check it, no syntax error. So I'll repeat once again. What is the file now? Cust2.txt. What is the change in that file? Instead of comma delimiter, we are having tab delimiter. Okay, so except for tab delimiter, or if you are having tab delimiter, I can use this particular parameter and set it to what? X. If it is other than tab, if it is comma, if it is semicolon, or if it is at the rate, you have to go for the earlier logic. You have to take a temporary internal table, get the data into that, then loop that internal table, split it based on what? That particular delimiter. But only for the tab delimiter, I need not take the temporary internal table. I directly took the final internal with how many fields? 3 fields. Why 3 fields? Because I know that my file, each record is having maximum 3 fields. So I declare that. Directly I am reading the data into that internal table by specify, by indicating SAP that the delimiter is what? Tab delimiter. Done. I got the data into this. Since this data I cannot directly insert into KN1 now, because this is having only 3 fields. Okay, but KN1 is having 215 fields. That's the reason I took one more internal table and I'm looping this and I'm what? Assigning it to what? Those internal table. Done. So how many records are there in my KN1 table now? 9160. Let me execute this. Okay, I'll debug also. I'll put the breakpoint. Yeah, what is the file now? Cust2.txt. Cust2.txt, done. F8. Yeah, if you see T underscore final, I got the data into that. Hello. I got the data. See this data? I got it field by field, because I get the delimiter as what? Tab delimiter. I got the data field by field. Then if it is not initial, I am looping it. Done, 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 done. It will loop for 4 times. After looping that 4 times, I'll get the data into what? Final internal table. What is the final table? GT underscore final. So you can see I got the data into the respective fields. It has got 215 fields. But I'm having the data only for 3 fields. So rest of the part is simple. I got number of records affected is what? 4. Now if you go back and check, I got 164. So what we understood is how to work with the files which are having tab delimiter and other than tab. Tab delimiter means I need to consider this particular parameter. That's all. That is a change. Any questions, please ask me. Okay, so today we understood how to read the data from local text file. Tomorrow what we'll do is we'll see how to read the data from Excel file, or if the file is there on the server machine, how to deal with that files. And we understood the limitation of direct input method. What is the limitation? It is not doing any checks. Directly the data is transferred from internal table to what? SAP. Okay, so my customer wants to do the checks. Only valid data should be migrated. Invalid data should be ignored. Okay, so those things will be can be done using what? Other BDC techniques. Any questions in this example, please ask. Done. So if you don't have questions, I'll wind off for today. Tomorrow we'll see other concepts of BDCs. Chalo then, so I'll wind off. We'll continue tomorrow.